Ever since human beings have existed, they've encountered new viruses, like the one that causes COVID-19. Today, encountering a previously unseen pathogen is like piecing together a puzzle. There are key questions about the pathogen, the symptoms it causes, the number of cases, the level of severity, and how to control the disease. The answers lie in science. Having learned from previous outbreaks, scientists combine equations and data to estimate the growth of the new epidemic, as well as the case fatality ratio, or percentage of cases who die of the disease. Sets of equations describing how the pathogen spreads between people can predict the effectiveness of various disease control options. These models help the government to decide how best to protect us. Some information about a new virus, such as its incubation period, emerges early in an outbreak. Data from a small number of people whose times of infection have been confidently identified can be used to estimate the distribution of incubation periods amongst the general population. But at crucial points of deciding what measures to take, policymakers won't have all of the data. For example, while an epidemic is still unfolding, a simple estimate of the case fatality ratio might be seriously misleading. Some infected people may be only mildly affected, and estimates from different countries may differ. It's crucial to understand if that's due to other diseases, varying access to healthcare, or approaches to detection. In the absence of an effective vaccine or treatment, the control of a virus depends on non-pharmaceutical interventions. These include the measures COVID-19 made us familiar with: isolating symptomatic cases, providing healthcare workers with personal protective equipment, tracing contacts, closing schools, and banning large gatherings. By definition, the puzzle won't be completely solved until the pandemic is over. But until then, scientific analysis and modelling provide a critically important framework for saving lives. For more fascinating science, visit our website, subscribe to our channels, and like us on social media.